Well, hello again, everyone. Professor Prophet coming to you from Craps University. And we've got a cool little roulette strategy for you this evening. This one is called Intersection. Now, this is a $1,000 buy-in. 10% win goal means we'll be looking to win $100, one of those bills with Benjamin Franklin's picture on the front of it. So we're going to be betting a column and then a double street, and those two will intersect. And that's why we call it the intersection strategy. Now, this is one of our building block strategies. So we'll start off small with small bets, and then we'll build those up as we miss some numbers until we finally do hit one of those numbers. And hopefully that'll be enough to get us to our session high and we can start over again. Now, this does have jackpot numbers. You know, we love those jackpot numbers, and this one includes those. So we're looking forward to hitting one or two of those during the session. That'd be great. Now, if you like the video, we ask that you give us the thumbs up. That way we know you're enjoying the content. And also, if you have not already subscribed to the Craps University channel, man, we'd love to have you hit that button and become part of the student body here at Craps U. Now, as always, we do recommend that you try these strategies on your software at home or your table at home before you take them to the casino, and be sure that you're comfortable with them and that you're confident that they will win you some money. So let's head on down to the felt now. We'll show you the nuts and bolts of the intersection strategy, exactly how we bet it, exactly what that progression is, and then we'll spin the wheel for a few minutes and see if we can take $100 off the casino. So we'll see you down there shortly. All right, everyone, down here on the virtual roulette table, getting ready to spin our intersection roulette strategy. Now, this does require a $1,000 buy-in, so our 10% win goal will put us at a $100 win goal for this particular session. Now, the way this works, we start off with a $10 bet on the column and $5 on any one of the double streets. So let's say the 712, and then we spin. If we lose, we'll pick up a second double street. Let's say the 1924. And if we lose again, then we'll pick up a third double street. And we'll increase our bet to $10 on the double street on all three of these, and $20 on the column. Now, if we continue to lose, we'll go up a level, another $5 on each one of the double streets, and another $10 on the column bet until we reach the session high, and then we'll start back over at our base level. So let's go ahead and clear these out, and then we'll get started. Now, it doesn't really matter which column you pick or which double street on the column. I'm going to go ahead and just pick the one that's been the longest since it's hit. So we had the 9, which is the third column, the 22, which is the first column. So that means the second column is the longest. So we'll put $10 on that, and then let's put 5 on the 712. And let's spin. Now, this is somewhat of a volatile system. But we do have some jackpot numbers, so we like that. That's a loss there. So we'll just rebet. And let's pick up the 1621 double street on this one. And the jackpot numbers now would be the 811 and the 1720, because that would hit both the double street and the column. It'll hit in that intersection. So that's why we call it the intersection strategy. All right, down 15. Let's see if we can hit one here. That's a 18 red. And so we do hit the double street on that. So that's a $10 win. So let's go to, see, that was the third column. 34 would be first column. Let's go to second column. And we're at $10 there. And we've got two double streets. So let's go 49. And 22 through 27. And let's spin it. Down 5 now, looking to get to our session high with the hit here. 12 red. And that is a loss, so we'll just rebet these and pick up that third double street. 31, 36 on this one, we'll increase that to 10. And we'll bring these other two bets up to 10 and the column bet up to 20. So on up to the next level, and down 25 for the session. And that's 28 black. So that's another loss. So we'll just rebet and go up another level And that'll put us at 15 on the three double streets and 30 now on the column. So that's $75 total bet. And that's 13 black. So that's another loss. And we're kind of on a cold streak here. So what we're trying to do now, we've got these bets up a little, pretty high. If we could hit one of these jackpot numbers, that'd make up a lot of ground for us. 27 red, and that is a double street hit, so that's a $20 win. So let's go ahead and stay right where we are and spin it again. Still down 130 now and looking to hit a jackpot number. That's 21 red this time, and that's a loss. So we'll go up another level. 125 bet on this one, down 230 now. 33 black, and that's a double street win. So we'll just stay at this same level, rebet and spin again. Here's 11 black, and that's a column hit. So let's switch columns, 33. So we'll go to column one now. And I believe we were at 50 on that. And we've got three of these double street bets to pick up. And we got 25 on each one of those. And we're spinning down 180 now. Coming back a little bit. Double zero, that's not going to help the calls any, the green monster there. So let's rebet and go up another level now. That puts us at 30, 30, and 60. And down 305 now. So you can see why we need a pretty sizable bankroll here. So that's a $30 win as we hit 20 black, which is a double street win for us. So let's rebet and re-spin. 26 black this time. And that's another double street win for us. So let's rebet and spin again. 19 red. And there's a jackpot number, a $210 win. So that puts us at down 35. So let's go ahead and reduce these bets. Let's go back down to, say, level two now. And so let's pick up the 4-9 for 10, the 13-18 for 10, and the 25-30 for 10. And the longest that it's been to hit a column, that would be column three. So let's do 20. On it, let's spin it and see if we can get back to our session high, which right now is zero. We hadn't hit anything yet. So there's 35 black. That's a loss. So let's go up another level. So go 15 on the double streets and 30 on the column. And much coverage as we had, we've got a really cold wheel right now. And there's another miss. So let's go up another level here. So we got 12, 16, we got 24 of the numbers covered and we keep missing. So that can't go on forever. We're bound to start hitting one here in a minute. So there's 30 red. So that's going to be a column hit for us. And that's actually going to be a jackpot hit for us. So that puts us at 20 down. So let's go back to level two. And second column is the longest since it's hit, so we'll do 20 there. And let's do 10 on the 10-15, 22-27, and the 16-21. We'll shoot for something in the middle here. Thirteen black is the number, so that's going to be a double street hit. That's a $10 win. So we'll rebet, and we're only down $10 on the session now, and just trying to get back in the positive. So one red is the number, so that's going to be a loss. So we'll rebet and add $5 on the double streets and 10 on the column, $75 total bet. And there's 32 red. So that's going to be a column hit for us. So we'll go to the third column now. So do 20 there. And let's do 10 on the 4, 9, 16, 21, 28, 30. Actually, I think we're at 15. So let's go up another level. And let's spin it. Here we go. 36 red. So that's another column hit for us. So now we're down 30. So let's go to column 1. And let's pick up the 712 for 15. The 1621 for 15. And the 2530 for, you guessed it, 15. So still down 30 on the session. So there's 9 red. So that's a double street hit for us. That's a $15 win. So let's go back with the same bet. And still down 15. 25 red this time is the number. And there's a jackpot number. That's a $105 win. And that puts us up 90. So now we'll go back to our base level. So the second column is the longest since it's hit. So we'll do 10 there. And let's do the 4-9 for 5, the 16-21 for 5, and the 28 through 33 for 5, $25 bet. And let's see if we can hit one of them. There's 33 black, and that is a hit. That's a $5 hit. Now, I did mess up there. I should have just gone with one double street, but it's been so long since we've been back to the base level, I just messed that up. So right now we are, let's clear these out. We don't want to do that. See where we are. We're at 95. So let's go first column for 10. And let's go 7 through 12 for 5. And we're spinning. Here we go. And that's 28 black. So that's a win for us, a $15 win. And that is $110. So that is our win goal plus 10. And that is how the intersection roulette strategy works. Now, again, the reason we call it the intersection is because we have the column bet and a double street bet. We have that intersection, in this case, would be the 1720, which are our jackpot numbers. So, and that is why we call it the intersection strategy. Now, we started off with the $1,000 buy-in, ended up at $1,110. So that is a $110 profit. So we'll leave with $1,000 of our own money and $110 of that sweet, sweet casino cash in our pocket. So we hope you enjoyed that video. If you did, we ask that you give us the old thumbs up. And that way we know that you are enjoying our videos. And also, if you haven't already subscribed to the Craps University channel, we'd sure love to have you go ahead and become part of the student body here at Craps U. Once again, we do thank you for joining us, and we hope you will come back and visit with us again real soon. Until then, if you're out there spinning that wheel, we wish you nothing but the best of luck, and we hope all your numbers come up winners. Talk to you again soon. Bye-bye.